Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Marwa Kaisey. I'm a board certified neurologist, and today we're going to be talking about something that I am fanatical about, and that is sleep. I don't think a single one of my long-term patients has gotten away from me without us having a whole conversation about their sleep. And I want to talk to you about the top three sleep mistakes that most people make. But first, let's talk about why sleep is even important, why I'm fanatical about it. I have found in my experience that if you're sleeping poorly, it's going to make other things like depression and memory issues worse. And sometimes we can fix or help these things just by fixing sleep. I wasn't always this big a fan of sleep. In college, I would regularly sleep 5 hours just because there was so much to do and I didn't need it. And then I got to medical school where there's a lot of memorization, there's a lot of cognitive work, you gotta really be on your game and be sharp. And I found that I could not function well or at my best with less than 8 hours of sleep. And this is pretty common for most of us. Most adults need 7 to 9 hours of sleep. There are very rare examples of people who can get away with about 4 hours of sleep, but for just about everybody else, that's not the case. And a lot of people are fooling themselves into thinking they're just fine with 6 hours of sleep, what they really need more. Science has shored this up in the last few years. Really, the research has changed and shown that people who sleep less, as little as 6 hours a night in their middle age, are at a higher risk of dementia, 30% higher increased risk of dementia by the time they hit their 70s. So there's this link now between sleep and how our brains function. What is the underlying reason for that, right? What is the theory here? And it all probably goes back to something called the glymphatic system, which is our brain's waste removal process. This was not described until 8 years ago, right? There's a whole process in the brain for the brain taking out its trash that we didn't even know existed until 2013. But basically, it's a process where the brain removes all the waste proteins, and it does this while we're sleeping. It's activated while we're asleep. So you can imagine if you don't get enough sleep, all the waste in your brain, all that garbage is building up over time, and that does nothing for you long-term as far as your long-term mental capabilities. So, what are the top three sleep mistakes and how can you fix them other than sleeping enough, right? That kind of goes without saying that we need 7 to 9 hours of sleep and everybody's different within that range, so you kind of got to find your sweet spot. But the top three sleep mistakes that people make are number three, not treating an underlying sleep condition or things that are interfering with sleep due to other medical conditions. So these can be things like not treating sleep apnea. So if somebody's snoring a lot and they stop breathing or they sound like they stop breathing in their sleep, they may have sleep apnea, should definitely get that checked. Not treating more rare sleep disorders like something called REM behavioral disorder, where people literally act out their dreams as they're sleeping, and that can definitely interfere with their sleep, but also with the sleep of anyone who's in the bed with them, as you can imagine. And then not treating things like bladder issues or pain that may be making you wake up in the middle of the night and interrupting your long-term or your long sleep cycles. Number two is not respecting circadian rhythm. So we already talked about how much sleep you're getting, but the timing of that sleep can also be important. So our brains release a natural hormone called melatonin to get us to sleep at certain points of the day or night and wake up at certain points in the day. And it usually correlates with the sun. So most people's circadian rhythm has them naturally going to bed between 10 and 11 and waking up at around 7 a.m. So trying to kind of find what your natural rhythm is, when you're getting sleepy, and when a natural time to wake up is important. And sticking to that, our bodies thrive on routine, including our brains. And so going to bed at around the same time every night and waking up at around the same time every morning, including on the weekends, will make you feel a lot more refreshed. There's a way to take this natural sleep hormone melatonin and kind of add to your body's or your brain's natural production of it. It is an over-the-counter supplement that you can buy, and I found a lot of people use this incorrectly. They're taking it like they would take a Tylenol about, you know, 30 minutes before they want it to kick in, or they think it'll kick in at that point. But really with melatonin, the way it works is you take it at around 2 or 3 hours before bedtime. Because our brain's natural melatonin starts to kick in around sunset, right? A few hours before we want to go to bed. So you take the natural, the extra melatonin, the over-the-counter melatonin, then the same way. You take it a few hours before your bedtime. And for most people, around 3 milligrams is okay, but talk to your doctor if you have any questions about the dosing itself. So that's one way to kind of trick your brain into getting on a circadian rhythm and getting into that cycle. But again, rhythm and routine and timing is important to feeling refreshed, just as getting enough sleep is important to feeling refreshed. And the last and one of the top sleep mistakes that people make is sleeping dirty, right? Which just basically means that we're not following sleep hygiene rules. So sleep hygiene has nothing to do with the cleanliness of your sheets or how often you wash them. It's about some techniques that really encourage good sleep. So some of these things include, this is a big one, and I am so guilty of not following this one, no screens before bedtime, about 30 to 60 minutes. It's really 60, but we say 30 because 60 is very hard to stick to. No screens, no phone, no TV, no computer, because again, our brains are primed to sleep when it's dark at night. So if you're introducing artificial light right before you go to bed, your brain's gonna think, hey, it's daytime, I should be awake right now, right? So it's a big driver of insomnia. So turn off those screens at least 30 minutes, ideally up to 60 minutes before bedtime, and let your brain kind of get into that mood of, okay, it's dark, it's time to rest. Other mistakes are working in bed. So you really want to reserve your bedroom if at all possible, and it's hard now that people are working from home a lot more in small spaces, but if you can, reserve your bed for sleep and for sex and for nothing else, because your body and your brain, again, are primed to kind of form these associations, right? So if you start to form an association between your bed and working, then you can imagine that no longer becomes a restful place where your brain associates the bed with rest and with sleep. So the same tune, making your bedroom a nice calm space, right? Turning down the lights before bed, putting on some calming music or lighting a candle, taking a warm bath or shower can help a lot too. So these are some sleep hygiene tips. There's a lot more online if you want to kind of Google it. They'll give you a whole list, but these are some of the top ones that a lot of people, and myself included, don't always follow, but that can definitely lead to good sleep. So just to summarize a little bit, sleep is super important to our mood, our cognition, and our long-term brain functioning, because sleep is the time when our brain takes out its trash. And that protects us from developing things like dementia in the long run. Almost all of us need 7 to 9 hours of sleep per night, and getting the same amount of sleep, the right amount of sleep for you within that range at around the same times every night can help make you feel a lot more refreshed. And you want to make sure that you're following some basic sleep rules, like treating any underlying medical conditions that are affecting your sleep, also to following sleep hygiene rules, and respecting your own circadian rhythms and your own routine. So I hope this has helped. Sleep well tonight, and I hope you feel rested in the morning.